This video I'll be talking about Hall effect, which is very so what I found is most of the information which you want to get from the sample is the Hall measurement. Most and longitudinal measurements are also important, but Hall measurements are like heart of the condensed matter experiment list for the transport guys, not everyone, but transport. I'm not talking about the transport guy. So there are two kinds of geometry available for Hall measurement. One is called Vander power geometry, one is called Hall effect. Hall is discovered by Edwin Hall and Van der Pauw, the Netherlands physicist. But let's talk about the Hall bars first. So now Hall bars, you normally have a one. This is source, and this guy is drain, and then you can measure Hall resistance here across these two terminal, and you can measure longitudinal resistance like this. So the minimum you need is 5 probe. But you can add a 6 probe also, which will only help you. So the how do you measure a Hall effect is very, very simple. It's basically a Lorentz force is happening, when you apply, and here the magnetic field is applied perpendicular to the sample. So what will happen is you'll force the electron to go towards the one corner and holes towards the other corner. Now the derivation is very simple. I'll not go through it, but just I'll give a formula. It just give a hint that it is a Lorentz force and steady state F is 0. You plug in all the formula, for example, J is equal to Ne Vd, Vd is the drift velocity. In the end, what you'll get is this. V Hall is Ib by Nte, N is the number density, T is the thickness, E is the electron charge, like 1.6 minus 19. So with the Rh, which is called Hall coefficient, you can get your number density. That's the way. You can also get the mobility also if you have the longitudinal resistance. It's one of the way to do it. Now this is a perfect way to measure Hall resistance. And one important thing I want to mention here, that if there is a some, for example, I have drawn deliberately this probe here little bit, this will give asymmetry in the data, so you need to correct it. But if they're done lithographically and they're perfect within 1 micron range, you don't get normally misalignment in the data. But we'll talk about this asymmetry. I realize that you need to make another video for that. Now another one is called Van der Pauw geometry. Van der Pauw geometry, so what you need to put a contacts really on the corner of the sample, and this has to be very, very small compared to the size of the sample. But in the real life, this is not the case. Normally you'll make contact, it's very hard. Normally you'll make contact on the, somewhere here, not on the exactly on the corner. You can make contact here also, which will not work, which is not recommended. So which is the drawback of the system. Now if you want to measure the longitudinal resistance with this guy, so what you need to do is you pass the current through here, you will measure the voltage here. This is one measurement. It's pretty tricky measurement, so you need to do it twice. In second case, you have to do it also to get, you have to do the both measurement. It's called horizontal, and this is called vertical, and this is called horizontal. So you pass current through here, measure voltage here, you pass current through here, measure voltage here. That's what I have done. Now to get the sheet resistance is nothing but rho is the resistivity divided by thickness. What you need to do is E minus pi r vertical divided by rs, E minus pi r horizontal divided by rs is equal to 1. So you solve this tangential equation, you'll get rs. So this is how to get the sheet resistance. Now the Hall measurement is really tricky. So if you see Hall measurement, you have to do 4 measurement to get 1 Hall data. So you have to measure 1, 3, 2, 4, 3, 1, 4, 2. It is always diagonal, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 4, 4, 2. And the way it is done is to get V13 exactly, you take V13 in the positive magnetic field minus V13 in the negative magnetic field. You have to do minus, which is very obvious, because after doing the minus sign, you'll get the Hall. So you do it 4 times. So totally it is 4 measurements, and which is quite a pain. To get the Hall voltage, you need to divide by 8, because everything is divide by 2, so you get divided by 8, and the formula is again same as the last time. So I'll say the Van der Pauw geometry is hard, but it is very easy to do compared to Hall bar. So there comes the advantage. So both of method has advantages and disadvantages. We decide what we have in our setup. That's all. Thank you.